boys and girls, I'm Hannah, and I am having so much fun learning about compassion, which is caring enough to do something about someone else's needs.
Hey, everyone! I heard we're going to be doing another experiment today, and I can't wait. I love experiments. Is this going to be about light again, Miss Hannah?
It sure is. You see, we are learning that when we show compassion to others, we are being like Jesus and shining his light.
Wow, that's awesome. I'm so excited.
Whoa, what was that?
Excuse me, that was my stomach. I forgot to eat breakfast.
Oh no, well, good news for you because our Bible story actually has food in it.
Ooh, food I can eat?
Well, you know, I think we should wait and see, but I have some food right here.
Miss Hannah, why do you have a random potato in your pocket there?
Well, you see, this potato isn't random, and it was not in my pocket. It's for our experiment.
Oh.
Yeah, you see, this potato is going to help us light up a light bulb.
What?
Yeah.
How? I mean, it's a potato.
Well, I'm going to show you. Now, kids, if you do this at home, what will you need to help you stay safe?
Oh, we need an adult's help.
That's right. Okay, so we have our potatoes, and I've already set this one up, but I'll kind of show you how it works.
Awesome.
Okay, so we have our potatoes, and we cut them all in half. So now we have four potatoes, okay? So we have one copper nail and one zinc nail in each part of our potato, about an inch apart. Then we're going to take wire, and we're going to connect from one potato to the other, one in the copper and one in the zinc. And you'll go all the way around the potato like that.
Cool.
Then for your last part, you're going to take your small little light bulb, just like this one, and you're gonna wrap it around each part. So one zinc nail and one copper nail.
Oh, then what happens?
Well, let me show you.
Miss Hannah, that's amazing. I mean, it's a small light, but from a potato?
Yeah.
I didn't think potatoes could glow at all.
Yeah, why? You see, the potato acts like a battery powering the light bulb. Now, if you added more potatoes, the light would glow much brighter.
Wow.
Yeah, you see, today in our Bible story, someone takes what they have, some food, and when it's given to Jesus, it turns into more and more and more. Just like adding more potatoes would make this light much brighter.
Wow, but how did Jesus turn something that someone had into more?
Well, I think you're just gonna have to listen to our Bible story to find out.
Oh.
Whoa, but before that, let's get you a snack.
Oh, some potatoes like french fries?
Well, I don't think you wanna eat these potatoes, but we definitely could get some french fries or maybe some goldfish instead.
Oh, I like goldfish. They're orange like me, Miss Hannah.
Yes, they are. All right, kids, you put on your listening ears. And there might be some fish in our Bible story later too.
Yay,
see you
for
later.
Fish. Bye.
Hello friends, my name is Miss Janelle and we are talking about our big
idea
of compassion this month. Compassion is caring enough to do something about someone else's needs. In today's story, Jesus shows compassion to a large group of people. Now I found our story in the book of John in this book. What's this book called?
The Bible.
The Bible, that's right. And if it's in the Bible, then we know it's
true.
And that means that it actually really happened. In today's true story, Jesus showed compassion to the people around him. Our story begins with Jesus sitting on a hill with his friends, the disciples sitting around him. Now, while Jesus was sitting on this hill, he saw a huge crowd of people looking for him. The people were coming to see Jesus. There were over 5,000 people, and Jesus loved them all. Jesus knew that they would be hungry, and he wanted to help them. So Jesus asked Philip, one of his friends, where they could buy bread for all of those people. Philip was puzzled. They would need bread for more than 5,000 people. Think about how much bread that would be. It'd be a lot. And then think about how much money you would need to pay for all of that bread. That would be a lot too. Philip told Jesus that they would have to work for several months to pay for all of that bread, and they still wouldn't have enough money. Then Andrew, another one of Jesus's friends, told Jesus that there was a boy in the crowd who had brought a sack lunch. The boy offered to share his lunch. I have his bag right here. Let's see what is inside. Oh, it looks like some bread and some fish. Can you help me count the bread? Okay, here we go. One.
One.
Two.
Two.
Three.
Three.
Four.
Four.
Five. There are five loaves of bread. Okay, let's see how many fish are in here.
One.
Two.
Two
fish and five loaves of bread. Is that enough to feed more than 5,000 people?
No.
No way. That's not enough food for all those people. Well, Jesus' friends, the disciples, told everyone to sit on the grassy hill. And then listen to this. Jesus took the boys five loaves of bread and two fish, and he prayed and he thanked God for the food. And then Jesus asked his disciples to take this food and start passing it out to all of the people. So his friends went out and they gave some to this person over here and some over here. And they kept passing out all the food and they told the people that they could eat as much as they wanted. They just kept passing it out. And the people kept eating and eating until their tummies were full. Wow, that's a lot of food. Jesus fed more than 5,000 people with five loaves of bread and two fish. But wait, there's more. When the people were finished eating, Jesus told the disciples to take baskets out to the crowd and gather all of the leftovers so nothing was wasted. Let's see how much food was left. Wow, look at all this food. There's so much food left. The Bible tells us that there were 12 baskets of food left over. Whoa. Jesus took five loaves of bread and two fish and he fed 5,000 people. The people there that day got to see Jesus perform a miracle. I bet that was an incredible thing to see. The boy gave what he had to Jesus and Jesus was able to help a lot of people that day by feeding them. You can use what you have too to help others. It would have been easy for the boy to think that his little bit of food wouldn't have been enough to share with all of those people, but he was willing to share, and look what Jesus did. He fed more than 5,000 people with the boy's five loaves of bread and two fish. Now you might think that you don't have very much to share, but when you trust Jesus and you give what you have, you never know how God will use it to meet others' needs. Who can help others? I can help others. We can help others and show compassion by looking for what others need and sharing with them. I think that now is a great time to pray. So let's bow our heads, close our eyes, and we can talk to God. Dear God, thank you for our true story from the Bible, and thank you for sending Jesus to be our best friend. Help us to use what we have to share with others to help them. We love you, and all God's children said,
Amen. Amen.
I'll see you next time. Bye.
Let your light shine so others can see it. Then they will see the good things you do, and they will bring the glory to your Father who is in heaven. Matthew 5:16.
to be little, but now it's a wildfire. It's growing bigger and bigger and bigger. Can't shut it down, can't blow it out, can't hide it now. It's shining around the world and getting hotter now. So throw your light up, come on, raise it higher. We're gonna start a fire, it's only getting brighter. Burn bright in the night for the world to see. This little light is bringing change and it starts with me.
One hand high.